The early hours of the morning of Sunday, March the 5th, it's the one we've been waiting for. Judgment Day for Joe Calzaghe and Jeff Lacy, introduced by Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time has come for the bout you've all been waiting for, the unification showdown for the super middleweight championship of the world. Prepare to welcome the boxers as they make their way to the ring. First, ladies and gentlemen, entering to the red corner, the IBF and IBO world champion from St. Petersburg, Florida, in the United States, Jeff Lacy.
There's the IBF champion, Jeff Lacy. They say he's one of the hardest hitting fighters in the world in any division. And he says that the atmosphere here, a hostile atmosphere, will not affect him. I like being the underdog, he says. Well, here he is stepping into a crowd which must be 99% Joe Calzaghe. Cheers from the crowd. He's been pretty surly and non-communicative all week. He was a smiling figure when he came over a month or two ago when this fight was announced. But this week, he has just not wanted to know. Only stands about 5'9". But you'll see when he takes that tracksuit off, he has a physique which is absolutely ripped. He's in terrific condition. Jeff Lacy stepping into the ring, centre stage in the Manchester Arena in front of some 16,000 fans. And they, to a man and woman, seem to be making him well aware of what they think. There's the IBF belt. And Lacy just content to prowl the ring. What sort of thoughts are going through that head?
And now, ladies and gentlemen, entering to the blue corner, the WBO World Champion from Newbridge, Wales, Joe Calzaghe.
Joe Calzaghe gets the hero's welcome. Have made the journey up from Wales, but this is an appeal of a fight for the entire country. Calzaghe getting a colossal reception. Calzaghe has been here, done it so many times before, but never quite on a stage like this, in front of so many people. This is the defining fight he has craved. Now 33 years old, saluting his public. But how will his hand stand up? Is he fit enough to repel one of the meanest men in boxing? Rounds it's due to go. 12 3-minute rounds, a unification fight, and there are the rules. No 3 knockdown rule, no standing 8 count. The fighters cannot be saved by the bell. If there's an accidental clash of heads inside 4 rounds causing the end of the fight, it's a no contest. After that, it goes to the cards. That's the rules for this fascinating fight. Enzo Calzaghe, father and trainer of Joe right the way through his career. A lot of experience in that corner. He will have to be absolutely at his very best if he's going to win this fight tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing to you our three judges scoring this bout from ringside. From Las Vegas, Nevada, in the United States, Adelaide Bird. From London, England, Roy Francis. And from San Juan, Puerto Rico, Nelson Vasquez. And introducing to you, ladies and gentlemen, our third man in the ring, working in this, his 90th world title bout, Raul Cais Sr. All right, fans, here we go. The time has come for the main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the unified super middleweight championship of the world. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, live from Manchester, England, it's showtime! Introducing you first on my right, the WBO champion fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black trunks with white trim, hailing from Newbridge, South Wales. He weighed in at an even 12 stone, 168 US pounds. He is undefeated in his illustrious campaign of the ring with 40 wins, no losses, 31 wins coming by way of knockout tonight. He is making the 18th defense of his title. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the undefeated WBO super middleweight champion of the world. Please welcome the pride of Wales, introducing Joe Calzaghe. And his opponent across the ring, the IBF and IBO world champion on my left, fighting out of the red corner, entering the ring wearing red, white, and blue trunks, and fighting out of St. Petersburg, Florida, in the United States. His weight, 11 stone, 13 pounds, or 167 U.S. pounds. He is a U.S. Olympian, undefeated in the professional ranks, with a record of 21 wins, no losses, one no decision, with 17 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, in his sixth appearance in a world title, here is the undefeated IBF and IBO super middleweight champion of the world, introducing Jeff Lacy. Once again, the referee in charge, Raul Cais Sr., now to give instructions, 12 rounds of boxing scheduled.
Referee calling the two men together for final words of instruction.
All right, gentlemen, the time you've been waiting for is here. The opportunity of a lifetime, so remember, take advantage. You had your instructions, bone here, right here is fine, both of you got it, trunks high. Shake hands, good luck to both of you.
Well, this is the one we've been waiting for. The unification fight that Joe Calzaghe has craved for so long. It has arrived. 12 rounds, Joe Calzaghe against Jeff Lacy. They say it's the biggest super middleweight title fight since Roy Jones against James Toney back in 1994. Calzaghe fighting out of the southpaw stance, the taller man by a couple of inches. And will he be content to try and just box his way to victory?
I don't know if he's going to get the chance to box his way to victory because, you know, Lacy's just going to come looking for him. This is where he needs to have the fight up close.
Calzaghe breaking out of that clinch well with a right hand to the body, followed by the nice little jab into the face of Lacy. Another one. Calzaghe, I know, has been thinking he's got to try and keep his punches straight, try and fight at range as far as he can. But there is always that macho streak in Calzaghe. When he gets tagged, he likes to reply to fire with fire of his own. started nice and confidently though. Bit of attempted use of the head, I think, from Jeff Lacy in close. They made him shave off that beard that he's been sporting in the run-up to the fight.
Well, Calzaghe's got the higher work rate. You know, he can fight like this for 12 rounds, you know, at a much harder pace than Lacy. But Lacy obviously is the puncher of the two.
I do rather think that Calzaghe technically might be the better boxer. But is the edge in power with Lacy?
You know, Lacey's got scar tissue underneath his left eye. You know, he'd be the one to cut. I think if this is going to go to cuts or anything like it, but this is what you expect from Lacy. Just going to come looking for Joe.
Right hand from Lacy. He landed one to the body and then a big swing. And straight away, as Calzaghe gets hit, he starts going into a tear-up. Here goes the work rate from Calzaghe. Remember, the left hand is the fragile one. He can't afford to have that one damaged. Just lost his balance slightly in that exchange. The Lacy camp have gambled that Calzaghe is a fighter in decline and that he's a man ready to be taken.
Joe's already started his assault. He's not really throwing too many headshots. He's aiming him at the body because he knows his hands might be a little bit fragile, but you watch him when he starts to go to work.
Calzaghe's boxed quite neatly in this opening period. He's favouring the right hand clearly. But so far, he's got the speed to just jab his way in and then content to tie Lacy up in close. And Calzaghe will be happy with the way this first round has gone.
Lacy can't match Calzaghe for work rate.
He's just coming crouching in. There's a right hand. That's the best shot from Lacy so far. That's the danger punch.
That shot, Calzaghe. This is what you get from Calzaghe when he's hurt. He's like an out-of-control winger where he just starts firing shots.
Well, that's the first round to Calzaghe, but he did take a big right hand. Calzaghe working well behind the jab in the early exchanges. And then the flurry of punches when the action really hotted up.
Game plan. I want one round now, you box his ass off.
In the other corner, Dan Birmingham is the trainer speaking to Jeff Lacy.
Put your left foot outside. Listen, it's normal. Put your mouth.
Step quick. Deep hands lead. Bang, bang. Drop that jab and bring the hook. He's dropping his hands. He's wide open. He's squared up.
Already the nose of Lacy seeping blood. There's that right hand from Calzaghe, but back came the Welshman, and he returned it with interest.
Well, Calzaghe's drawn first blood. Can't afford to take any sort of unnecessary risks against such a dangerous opponent, or champion, I should say, in Jeff Left Hook Lacy.
Yeah, you have to sort of pinch yourself to remember this is not just a title defence for Calzaghe. This is him trying to add another world championship belt.
Beautiful left uppercut inside there by Calzaghe.
Lacy going looking for headshots. These are the danger punches. That right hand is the one Calzaghe cannot afford to get caught with. Calzaghe outworking Lacy at this stage. Lacy trying to drag Calzaghe down onto the punch on the blind side of the referee. Calzaghe himself spinning Lacy now and trying to work away on the ropes. Good work rate from the 33-year-old undefeated Welshman.
See, Calzaghe pacing himself. He's boxing an intelligent fight thus far.
There's a low one there from Lacy.
Also, Calzaghe's got his protector pulled up as high as he can possibly get it, which is what we're not really accustomed to with Calzaghe, but we know Lacy bangs well to the body.
Oh, good uppercut from Calzaghe, really good shot. Lacy takes it well. Remember, Lacy was stung in the early stages when he fought Omar Sheikha. That was arguably the hardest title defence so far, and he came back and won it well in the end. Good jab from Lacy this time, snapping shots, and Calzaghe just walked onto that one.
I just feel Calzaghe's getting engaged a little bit too early for my liking. I'd like to see him use the ring more. Not be flash, just be sensible. going to use the ring more, try and put some points in the bag, try and make Lacy look a little bit cumbersome, because Lacy doesn't quite have Calzaghe's footwork or hand speed.
Calzaghe needs to snap the jab, needs to work behind that right hand lead. That's his key to this fight.
It's better boxing from Calzaghe, and a little treble jab and just a little step off, you know, make Lacy, make him miss, make him pay. Lovely right uppercut.
Calzaghe is outboxing Lacy at this stage, but it's a 12 round fight, and a little contemptuous smile from Calzaghe as he tags Lacy almost at will. Lacy wants this to be in tear up. He's trying to urge Calzaghe in.
Well, this is pretty much what I thought we'd get from Lacy. He's not getting it his own way, and he's already starting to complain.
This is a really good start from Calzaghe, but Lacy now is into his face, and that's where he wants to be. Good uppercut again from Calzaghe, picking the shot well, and nothing coming back in there from Lacy. It's all Calzaghe in that exchange. Well, a brilliant opening from Joe Calzaghe. Dan Birmingham, Lacy's trainer, protesting vociferously to the referee about something.
Don't try to loop the hand right hand right now. Let him wear out a little bit. Straight punch, straight punch. Bang, bang, right hand. Bring the hook up to the body. Bring it up.
Trying to get those hooks into play. They call him left hook Lacy. We've not seen it yet. What a good start to this fight from Joe Calzaghe. Really good effort. And Lacy at the moment is being set problems to which he doesn't have the answer.
Well, you've got to expect a change of tactics from Lacy. He's going to have to really start to bully Calzaghe. He's going to have to up his work rate, but then you can expect Calzaghe to go straight with him.
Oh, good shot from Calzaghe. Short, straight left. Lacy into his face. Those are low punches, surely.
Yeah, this is getting really messy now.
But
really,
the referee can't see it. He saw where he was placed, right behind the back of Lacy. Calzaghe gets away with it.
Calzaghe's going to have to fight his way out of the corner.
He doesn't want to be in that sort of toe-to-toe terror.
A twist turn Lacy nicely there.
Well, that's good work from Calzaghe. Quality work, but can he keep this sort of intensity of performance, this sort of speed, this work rate, going for 12 rounds? Had to do it a few years ago against Charles Brewer down in Cardiff. That was a great fight that night.
Well, I think he can, John. Just needs to box sensible now, needs to go missing. He's boxing fantastically well so far.
He's making Lacy look ponderous in there, but we know Lacy has fitness and strength. Blood is still seeping from Lacy's nostrils. Good right hand from Calzaghe. If he is the slapper that Jeff Lacy says, he slaps hard.
Now this is going to be the hardest fight of Calzaghe's life, but right now he's boxing the fight of his life. Lovely combination, and then spins off and leaves Lacy to hit in thin air.
He is giving him a boxing lesson.
Absolutely, John. Giving him an absolute boxing lesson. He's hitting him and he's not getting hit. This is fantastic boxing by Calzaghe.
Brilliant from Calzaghe at this stage. Can he keep it going, though? Lacy, the man with dynamite in his fists. We know he's a terrific puncher. Easy, easy goes up the chant. Well, I think that might be tempting fate just a little bit.
Well, it's not easy, John, because he's having to work for this.
Outstanding opening from Calzaghe. Won the first two rounds, and he's absolutely dominant in this third so far.
See, Lacy's just become very pedestrian, very one-paced. You know, like all punchers, has to rely on him setting his feet to get those big punches off. And while he's doing that, Calzaghe's outboxing him.
Well, I always thought Lacy was one-paced, Duke, but the thing about him is that he does bang that big right hand, and as Calzaghe tires, if he can't get Lacy out of there, as he tires, that could be more of a factor. But look at that hand speed from Calzaghe. That is exceptional, absolutely exceptional.
One, two, three punch combinations and then missing. Calzaghe just goes missing. Showing out now. His confidence is growing by the round.
Well, that is a brilliant 3 minutes boxing from Joe Calzaghe.
right hand every time.
Okay. When you're inside like that, give him a little push. A little
I don't
push,
think that Jeff Lacy can quite believe what's going on in there. He's finding no way of getting to Calzaghe after that right hand early on.
He's just trying to bomb everything.
He looks bemused.
Come on, you gave away the first three. He cannot keep that pace.
He cannot keep that pace, says Dan Birmingham.
Come on, Jeff.
Well, we will see.
Straight right hands. And drop them down a little bit.
The jab is starting to get weaker. Big jab, right? Don't come. Keep it long.
A brilliant opening to this fight from Joe Calzaghe. Look at the hand speed and the mobility. If that's the performance of a waning fighter, it certainly doesn't look like it so far, but can he keep it up?
Yes, he can, John. We've seen this from Calzaghe before, and yes, he can keep this pace up. Lacy looking a little bit sorry for himself in his corner there. Corner just starting to get a little bit anxious now.
Enzo Calzaghe saying use the jab as Lacy tries to tee off an uppercut. He said to Calzaghe, box your way in, don't just get dragged into the tearer. Well, Calzaghe almost showboating there, shows him the right hand and then landed a peach of a straight left. Calzaghe coming under attack himself.
Yeah, this is where Lacy wants it. He just wants to apply pressure on Calzaghe. You know, he's hoping that the pace will drop where he can land these big overhand rights and the famous left hook.
I assume you scored the first three rounds to Calzaghe, Duke.
I've given Calzaghe everything. And I'm not being biased. I just see Calzaghe outworking Lacy completely. Lacy's cut.
Lacy's cut around the right eye. And it doesn't look good. That's going to be a lot of work for the corner between rounds. Well, it looks as though it's that damaged left eye. He had scar tissue there, and it looks as though it's opened up again, and they're going to have a look at it, I think, are they? He's saying it's a clash of heads, is Lacy. It goes to the end of the fourth round. It goes to scorecards. This one is the fourth round. If it were to be stopped, if the referee says that it's an accidental clash of heads that's caused it, but no suggestion that the referee is saying that to this point. And there's an air of desperation about the work of Jeff Lacy. He knows that he's cut, he may not have been hurt, at least not hurt badly, but the fight is going against him because Calzaghe is giving him a boxing lesson.
Well, there was scar tissue coming into on his left eye coming into this fight, and the cut's opened up, I think, on the right eye. I'm not exactly sure.
It is the right eye, Duke.
Yeah, the right eye. But Calzaghe is actually doing a number on him. His boxing is such an intelligent fight. You know, Lacy looks just a little bit desperate, a little bit clumsy. Doesn't have the same footwork as Calzaghe, doesn't have the hand speed of Calzaghe.
Nigel Benn said this week that if Calzaghe had been around in his era, the era of Chris Eubank, of Steve Collins, of Michael Watson, he could have stood the test with all of them. Clash of heads inside there. Lacy came boring in low, but he took a load of punches from Calzaghe as well, flurries of shots. And Lacy, for all his attempts to force the fight here, has not landed really one clean shot, for my way of looking at it, on Calzaghe in this round.
Yeah, there's been nothing of real any significance landed by Lacy. Sure, he's forcing the fight, but Calzaghe's just totally dominating and outworking him.
Closing stage from the fourth, and it's another Calzaghe round, and look at this! Terrific work from Calzaghe! And it's a bad one over the left eye, and I think the right eye is damaged as well. His face is a mess, and it's not, I don't think, clashes of heads that's done that. It's been the accuracy, the precision and sheer brilliance of Calzaghe's punching. They've got to do something to stop that. That is a mess. They don't appear to be doing anything with that cut.
Jeff, okay. Jab right hand. You got to get off first. You're waiting.
All right.
You're waiting, Jeff. Jab right hand and let him go.
Bad damage to the eyes of Jeff Lacy. And what a spectacular onslaught from Calzaghe. There was a clash of heads there, but that's not damage to the eye. That's hitting low. Not that clash of heads which has caused the damage. Not to my way of looking at it. and they're very slow to get out of the corner there. Deep cuts on Lacy's face. Fight should be underway. And the corner man in the Lacy camp, very slow to get out. And Calzaghe may be on his way now towards victory. Surely he's won all four rounds, but he can't get careless. Lacy still has that power.
Lacy really needs to get at the races now and try and, you know, assert himself in this fight, because he's in danger now of not only being stopped, but probably being on cuts, but he's being outworked and outboxed like Calzaghe.
Desperation from Lacy as he comes forward, trying to wing those trademark hooks, catches Calzaghe with one there. But so far, the overhand right, which is a real danger punch, hasn't been in evidence. Calzaghe's kept him away, and another lovely flurry of punches from Calzaghe.
Right now, Lacy doesn't appear to have an answer to the southpaw style. It's causing him all kinds of problems because he's catching everything on the way in. There's no lateral movement from Lacy, and this is probably one of his biggest downfalls. Sure, he's got the power, sure, he's got the skill, sure, he's got the arsenal, but he doesn't have the lateral movement to get out of the way of what's coming back at him.
Although he wouldn't say as much, I always got the impression there was just a hint of jealousy and maybe even a tad of resentment in Joe Calzaghe about the lack of recognition for his achievements and the fantastic support up here in Manchester for Ricky Hatton. Well, here tonight he's proved himself to be a fighter of the very top draw so far, and Ricky Hatton, who's in this crowd, I'm sure is watching on with a great deal of admiration.
Well, Lacy's punches are very predictable, and Calzaghe can read them really easily at this point. But he's found lovely combinations, and Lacy's face is a mess.
This last 12 rounds, goodness knows what sort of state Lacy's face is going to be in by the end of it. Already in the fifth round, he looks as though he has had an absolute pounding, and another straight left thuds in towards those damaged eyes.
Lacy's really struggling with this one, I promise you. Not only from the cuts, but he just can't work out this style. He can't get his punches off. It feels like he's giving him another boxing lesson.
He's had his ears boxed off. Lacy said, southpaw style doesn't matter one jot to me. I've had goodness knows how many rounds sparring with Winky Wright, but so far he's had no answer to this. Calzaghe bullies Lacy back across the ring. The referee says don't do that, but it's not a tea party.
Lacy's just ploughing forward, but he's not throwing anything. He's like a catcher at the minute, he's like a catcher's mitt. He's just catching everything that Calzaghe's throwing. He can't keep his combinations going. He can't match Calzaghe for hand speed or work rate.
Calzaghe's contemptuously now dropping his gloves, almost inviting Lacy in. Well, the rout continues, all Calzaghe, and that, oh dear me, that face is just a mess. That is a mess. Look at the eyes of Jeff Lacy. I thought at the press conference on Thursday, behind that grim, threatening demeanour lurks genuine tension, if not fear, of what might be coming. Now he knows his worst nightmares are coming. Lacy has been on the receiving end of a non-stop pounding in this fight. Five rounds out of five to Joe Calzaghe, and the Welshman so far is having things his own way and is boxing quite superbly.
You know, they're waiting for the pace to drop, but he's going to be waiting all night because Calzaghe can do this all night long. But he mustn't get overconfident. He has to stick with his game plan, hit and not get hit. Tie Lacy up, spin off, and just go missing and keep feeding in this stream of accurate, brilliant, quite brilliant combinations.
I'm sure in the corner, Enzo Calzaghe will have been drumming in the instruction, keep working off the jab, try and keep it at range. There it goes, rocking back the head of Lacy.
See, it's okay for Lacy to, you know, get fed a string of guys that he can just stand in front of him, and you know they're almost fearful because once they get in front of him, they see this muscle man in front of them, and then they end up getting knocked out. But Calzaghe won't stand for anything like that.
Calzaghe's never had the respect he should have had in the United States, through no fault of his own. He didn't get the contests against the likes of Roy Jones and Bernard Hopkins, and look at that quality. There must have been about a 7 or 8 punch flurry of blows there aimed by Calzaghe, and I think just about every one of them hit. Another good left hand, and Lacy is starting to look bemused, befuddled and utterly on his way towards defeat.
He's coming apart at the seams, John. What a beautiful combination we got there from Calzaghe. Controlled, pinpoint, accurate punches. 4, 5, 6, 7 punches all hit on the mark, on the button. Lacy looks really sorry for himself, and he's getting more and more banged up in now.
It's not only Lacy who looks sorry for himself. Gary Shaw, his promoter on the far side of the ring, looks one of the most shell-shocked men I've seen in a long time. Shelley Finkel, one-time manager of Mike Tyson, isn't exactly putting out the bunting either. There's the right hand, though. That's the danger shot.
All heads spinning dangerously close there from both boxers.
There was a right hand over the top from Lacy, which did get in.
Yeah, Calzaghe felt that, but he's still winning the round.
Clubbing right hand. Wonder how much more of this Lacy can take.
Yeah, Joe's, he's going to be tired, isn't he? Let's get it right. He's thrown a hell of a lot of punches. And, you know, but Lacy's not capitalising this.
Only one punch, though, Duke. It can still turn around. Don't count chickens. Calzaghe is boxing superbly, he's winning the fight, but Lacy is still in there, blood now seeping from his lower lip. Oh, headshots, those are the slaps, and he slaps hard.
Let's go, Joe Calzaghe.
Relaxed and confident.
You're sickening him now, Joe.
Absolutely on his game, isn't he? Look at that superb flurry of punches. I said 7 or 8. There might have been 9 or 10.
It was 10 unanswered shots. 9 out of the 10 hit the target. What a fantastic boxing we've got from Joe Calzaghe.
Marvin Hagler said he deserves to be ranked in the best 6 in the world, pound for pound. Jeff Lacy was supposed to be the coming star. Doesn't look like one there. It's been all Joe Calzaghe as we move into the second half of the fight.
Yeah, I've got Calzaghe winning everything. I think he's absolutely boxed rings around Lacy. He's absolutely given him a boxing lesson.
Calzaghe, in case I needed to remind you, of course, the taller man in the black and white shorts. Lacy, the man who's been battered from pillar to post for 18 minutes. Blood flying across our commentary position. Maybe coming from the eye of Jeff Lacy, no doubt.
This is all typical Calzaghe right now, which is what you're getting. You know, we're so used to seeing him fight like this.
What okay. A good straight right-hand lead he had in there. Now here comes Lacy, desperately trying to come in and wing hooks. There's his girlfriend, Jennifer, in the corner, trying to urge her man forward. But Calzaghe doesn't box his way out of it. He tries to get into a trading session.
And Calzaghe's obviously learned from his mistakes, because when he starts his combination, he keeps his chin down. When he's been hurt or he gets backed up, he keeps his chin down as he starts to throw his shots. Look where his chin is, right in his chest. He doesn't want to leave it hanging out to dry. He's boxing a great fight.
Lacy did get in with a left uppercut, as you were saying that, Duke. Just got in close. Calzaghe takes it well, though. Been down in a couple of fights recently against Byron Mitchell, Kabari Salem. That was an untidy fight, but Calzaghe was right in the middle of a messy divorce at that time, and thankfully for him, that's behind him now.
Joe took a right hand there off Lacy, but he's still there, obviously.
Lacy's probably having his best round of the fight so far.
Yeah, just landing one or two cleaner shots. He's getting outworked, but he's landing, he's just starting to get through on Calzaghe. Calzaghe's still winning this round for me, though.
going to have a headache tonight is Mr. Lacy. Taking so many shots, and again flurries of punches from Calzaghe.
Well, I want to see what Lacy says after this fight. If Calzaghe goes on to be victorious, which I think he will be.
There's moaning about use of the head from Calzaghe.
He wants to get on with it because this is World Championship Boxing and anything goes. He's getting worked over and he doesn't like it.
Calzaghe, I think, is starting to tee himself up for the big attack. I think he might be looking to take him out here. Two big left hands, and Lacy is on the receiving end of a barrage of punches. Calzaghe wants to get him out of there.
His legs have gone, John. He's all over the place. He's hanging on for dear life. He's trying his fight back, but Joe's just going to be a better punch, pick his punches better and get him out of there.
Somehow Lacy has seen it through to the bell. Calzaghe says something as he goes back, and he goes back to the corner where he gets terrific words of encouragement from Enzo Calzaghe. Lacy has never been down, but my goodness, he nearly went then. He came so close to being put down by those two left hands.
Right, it's fast and quiet this next round. Do one quiet.
There has not been one moment in this fight where Calzaghe has surrendered the initiative, and a punch count there would have revealed, I think, something in the region of 40 punches or more, which hammered in on Lacy in the last 15 seconds or so there. Dramatic.
Well, I said, you know, the worst thing Lacy can do is to hit Calzaghe and hurt him, because when Calzaghe recovers, he's like an out-of-control okay. And that's what we just saw. Just a set of quality punches. Lacy doesn't have the footwork to get out of the way. This fight could be over very shortly.
It's in all Calzaghe. I've got it as a complete shutout so far, Duke. Absolutely everything going to Calzaghe.
You know, Lacy was the betting favourite, but I just figured that he hadn't boxed anybody near of Calzaghe's class or stature.
6-4 on he was. 11-10 against Calzaghe. They were tasty looking odds. Still a chance for Lacy. While there's life, there's hope.
Oh, this is just, you know, Calzaghe's got his, right now Calzaghe's got his number. What a beautiful little combination. He's picking his punches beautifully. We're going right down the middle.
The hand has held together well. Dean Powell's done a good job binding up that weak left hand. I don't think there was too much sparring, if any, in the preparations of Joe Calzaghe for this fight. But then he's never been a big man for sparring in the gym, concentrating on fitness, boxing ability, and innate desire to win. He has a real winner's mentality, does the Welshman.
Now, how he's done it for this long, you know, 40 fight unbeaten record. You know, never ducked anybody, Calzaghe. You've got to really hand it to this boy.
Good left-hand lead from Lacy there. Caught Calzaghe as he came in. Lacy's just plodding. Straight left, and another left hand from Lacy. And is Lacy at last just starting to get to Calzaghe a little bit more, I wonder? Calzaghe, if he performs to type, will try and produce something terrific to catch the judges' eyes in the second half of this round.
It's a much closer round this round. Joe's probably needed to start just a little step off the gas, but as I say that, he comes back with a nice four-punch flurry. Beautiful boxing again.
Got himself into terrific shape. He's up on his toes, looking fresh and sharp, even at this stage.
Yeah, and let's not forget, you know, Lacy's been used to fighting on American soil, but now he's away from home. You know, I don't see him raising his game like he can do when he's back home.
Calzaghe's just allowed his work rate to drop a little bit in this eighth round, but then that's almost inevitable after the ferocious pace of the early stages.
Yeah, Joe's just looking just a little bit tired in this round. But, you know, you can't fault him for that because he's really worked hard. But Lacy's not paying him. He's not capitalising on what is actually happening in the fight.
Lacy has bull-like strength and he's trying to come charging in behind that spear of a left-hand lead. Calzaghe quieter this round. Has Lacy done enough to edge it? I'm not sure. Good uppercut inside from Calzaghe. And another one. Headshots, all scoring shots from Calzaghe.
Lacy breathing really heavily now as he soaks these punches up.
Well, that's the flurry of punches that we wanted to see from Calzaghe from a British point of view. Right in control. See what Barry McGuigan's making of it so far. You had your doubts beforehand,
yeah,
Barry.
I worried about him, but I have to tell you, he's been absolutely exemplary. Boxing brilliantly. What we, I suppose, overlooked was his speed, and certainly Jeff Lacy's overlooked his speed. He has absolutely bombarded Lacy, and Lacy has very little left in him. If he gets through another round of this, and remember, in the last round, Lacy took the round, or Calzaghe took the round off. He took an easy round. If he turns it on in this round, I'd be very surprised if Dan Birmingham doesn't pull Lacy out. He's taken an absolute hammering. There's very little left in him.
He's taking a pounding, and look at those shots which went in the closing seconds of that round. And Lacy, well, I was interviewed by one or two American journalists and American TV stations, and they looked at me with a look of bemusement when I said that Calzaghe might just be able to box this guy's head off. And they sort of thought I'd gone, lost my sense of reason, but there you go.
Well, you know, John, you're not the only one that thought Calzaghe would do this. You know, I know for a fact that his manager, promoter, Frank Warren's had a big bet on his boy. So, you know, he's not about to put him in a fight that he doesn't think he can't win. And, you know, what a gamble. He's paying off. So far, it's paying off. Lacy's going to need the knockout, you know, just to get back on even terms.
Gary Shaw, Lacy's promoter, bellowing at him while Calzaghe, just having the binding on his glove fixed by the corner. He is 8 rounds down, I reckon, Jeff Lacy.
That's good boxing by Calzaghe. Nice high guard. You know, just pecking away at the jab. Tying Lacy up. Sorry, John, just tying Lacy up on the inside there.
Left lead again from Lacy. Calzaghe, good body shot, good left hand. Oh, beautiful. Nice uppercut.
Absolutely beautiful. That's world-class boxing. Beautiful left uppercut by Calzaghe, right up the pipe.
He said he wants Clinton Woods next as Joe Calzaghe. Clinton said he thought Calzaghe would beat Lacy. And if he's watching this, I wonder if he might be thinking twice about the possibility of going into the ring against Calzaghe. You remember, he said he would love to be a world champion at two weights, as well as unifying this title. Mikael Kessler, the Dane, is a spectator here. The WBA super middleweight champion, that's another possibility.
There's a big left hook there landed by Lacy, though. Calzaghe, for the first time in the fight, actually grimaced in a little bit of pain.
Forward comes Lacy, trying to, you can see why he's trying to set himself, trying to give himself an opportunity to throw that bingo right hand.
You know, let's not forget, Calzaghe, I believe, has boxed at a much higher level, and he's been in world title fights and won with one hand previously, but thankfully tonight both hands have held up, and this is the sort of boxing that he can demonstrate.
Oh, that is superb. Knocking the head of Lacy around. Oh, look at that.
He's treating Lacy with contempt.
That is an Ray Leonard trick.
Absolute contempt. Beautiful boxing by Calzaghe. Fantastic. Winding up the right hand. Showing him a jab. Hitting him with a left hook. Well, this is what a true world champion is made of. When you can dismantle a rival champion with the consummate ease that Calzaghe is, you know, this is a sign of the man's class.
I think he could be close to being stopped here, Lacy. The referee should be having a good look at this, and I think that a compassionate corner might also be taking a good look at him, because he is taking round after round of sustained pounding now, and Calzaghe is producing every shot in the textbook. All Calzaghe.
Every round, I've given him every round. I've struggled to give Lacy even a share of one of the rounds.
Another big, big round. And how much more can he take? Those eyes are closing. Wow. He's cut badly.
What round is it?
He's hurting.
Ninth.
He's saying, what round is it?
Second.
Well, he says he's okay. He could have fooled me. Punch after punch from Calzaghe. So Calzaghe saying, suck it up, dig deep, don't let it go away. Calzaghe in sight of achieving one of his fighting dreams and adding another title and beating an American star.
Well, Lacy looks tired, he looks dejected and looks incredibly sorry for himself. You know, really slow getting off the corner now. Almost punched to a standstill on that last round. This is absolutely textbook boxing from Calzaghe. He's not done nothing flash, he's not taken any chances. He's boxed well within himself.
He's been the 12 round distance 8 times to Joe Calzaghe. Lacy 3. Calzaghe knows exactly what it takes to win a fight. And here he is getting back behind the jab.
Lovely right left uppercut from Calzaghe. Fantastic shot. He just shortened his punches up on the inside, which is what you'd expect with a short arm fighter like Lacy. He would be better at the inside work, but Calzaghe's met him on the inside and totally outboxed him.
Lacy turned professional in 2001. By then, Calzaghe had been a world champion for more than 3 years. It's been a steep learning curve for Lacy from there. Was he overhyped? Maybe.
I wouldn't say he was overhyped.
Well, I do think that Calzaghe here tonight has produced. But, you know, I mean, he said that his performance against Chris Eubank was the best of his career, the hardest fight he's ever had. I think this is absolutely vintage Calzaghe. I think tonight he's been brilliant.
Absolutely, and I'll have to second that. The guy hasn't put a foot wrong all night long against a young, hungry, unbeaten champion, rival champion at that. You know, IBF champion, but it looks like if Calzaghe can maintain this for the remainder of this fight. Beautiful by Calzaghe. You know what a lovely left uppercut. They've obviously worked on that punch in the gym. It's paid off for him all night long.
You're watching one of the outstanding British champions in Joe Calzaghe. One of the very best. And Jeff Lacy looks disconsolate, doesn't he? He looks in some distress, he looks bemused, he's banging his gloves together, he's bravely coming forward. Well, I could imagine, sorry Duke, I could imagine many a fight where this might have been stopped by now. If this wasn't a world title fight, I think Lacy would have been out of there. Good work again from Calzaghe, and look at the spring in his step, still up on his toes.
Pure class from Calzaghe, leading with a straight left right hook.
Superb again.
Lacy's just getting beaten to the punch every time. Toe, outboxed, outpunched, outmaneuvered.
And he shook his head disconsolately, came forward and was promptly bundled through the ropes by Calzaghe. Another great round for Calzaghe. Utterly in control. Is that 10 rounds gone? I've given him everyone.
Everyone, John. I've struggled to give Lacy one round.
Well, there's his girlfriend, Joe Calzaghe's girlfriend, that is. And she'll be delighted with the way things are going.
Absolutely fantastic.
Absolutely fantastic, says Enzo Calzaghe. And well, he might.
It was just beautiful boxing by Calzaghe. Look at the way he leads off with the straight left. Well, in this instance, you know, like a 4-5 punch flurry, 6-7, 8 punches, all unanswered. It's as much as Lacy can do now to muster another attack. He's desperately tired. You know, I can see Calzaghe maybe stopping him in this round. If he really steps on it and goes for it, he could get a stoppage. There's no need, obviously.
Should he be left out to take more? He's going. Round 11. And it just continues. More of the same. That's not a knockdown, that was a punch.
Calzaghe is. Okay, Lacy lost his footing, but Calzaghe gave him a little shove. So take that with you.
And it shows that Lacy is just about spent, I think.
Yeah, he got nothing left. You know, he hasn't been able to get his confidence with his big left hook, which he bragged about, you know, throughout all of the build-up to the fight. Hasn't been able to hit the target at all, not cleanly. So as I said before, he's been outboxed, outmaneuvered, outpunched now by Calzaghe.
He said to me that if it goes to the decision, if it goes to the judges' cards, he wasn't sure that he'd get a very good decision from the judges. I think on that one, he's probably right. Calzaghe is absolutely a mile in front.
Well, he's been absolutely amazing tonight. Let's not forget, John, this, you know, we've said it before, this isn't another defence. He's fighting a rival champion. Some would have said that Lacy was, you know, on paper at least, a better fighter than Calzaghe. We always thought he was a harder puncher, but Calzaghe hasn't allowed him to land his punches. He's nullified everything Lacey's tried to do. He just totally demoralised him and outboxed him.
There's a lot of people who thought that Lacy was going to win this fight. And when they look back at this one and assess it, perhaps that should be remembered. Here comes Lacy, bravely coming forward once more. Calzaghe's binding around his right glove is coming loose. And now we go to the corner again to get that glove bound. Yeah, same, Duke. I mean, when they come to assess this fight, so don't doubt there'll be some who say Lacy just wasn't what he was built up to be. But it's very easy to be wise after the event. There are an enormous number of people, and not just commentators, I'm talking about people within the sport, who thought that Calzaghe was going to go, that he was ready to be taken.
Well, sure, there'd been one or two chinks in the armour, but what Calzaghe's proven to you, he's proven the doubt was wrong. He's got himself in absolutely tip-top shape. We haven't had a problem with the hands, and he's got textbook boxing.
Here comes Calzaghe again. Is he looking for the stoppage even at this stage?
Well, Lacy looks spent. He looks absolutely out on his feet.
The referee ought to be stopping this. He's getting an absolute hiding, is Lacy, and you worry about what sort of damage this is having to him. This is a... Well, it's not a career-ending fight.
Gone.
He's never going to be the same again after this, I don't think.
He's got nothing left, John. He's got nothing left.
The referee ought to be stepping in to stop this one.
Come on, John. Fantastic. Oh, this is just breathtaking stuff from Calzaghe. You know, I remember this boy. He was on a couple of my shows when he was just turned professional. Mickey Duff said, watch out for this kid. He's going to be something special.
Well, there wasn't wrong with that.
But since taking over from Frank Warren...
Oh, he's taken the points away from Joe Calzaghe. No. Can you believe that?
Oh, well, that's being kind to Lacy. That's the first round I've given him.
Well, I don't know what that's about. I suppose Calzaghe won the round, so it's actually scored a level round, isn't it? You can't... Even losing a point, you can't give that to Lacy.
You're fantastic, right? This guy, fuck all. This is you. You stop him last round. He's going to stop now. He's going to stop him now. Get the jab working, mate. Don't fool him.
Here's the attack from Calzaghe. I think the referee should have been stepping in there, Duke.
Well, Lacy took so many unanswered shots.
Here's the
little backhander. That's why he's done it.
Well, maybe with sober reflection, the referee spotted it. Let's see what's happening in the Lacy corner.
Last round, baby, you gotta do it. You gotta do it, baby. Last round.
You gotta let your hands go. You got 3 minutes to get this guy out.
Right on, baby, you gotta do it. You can say that again. If he could turn this round, it would be the most extraordinary turnaround in a fight I think that I've ever seen. Calzaghe has been superb tonight, absolutely superb.
Well, he hasn't put a foot wrong all night, John. There's nothing to suggest that he's about to do that. You know, the spring in his step, the snap in his punches. It's Lacy who's obviously the desperate one. And the desperate man can often be hurt, but he can be dangerous. But Calzaghe's a fighter through and through.
Can Calzaghe take him out, even at this late stage?
He's going again for him. Watch Lacy's legs, they're gone. Referee looks like he might step in here, John. He's gone, John, he's absolutely gone. Referee's got him intervene. Look at his punches on Lacy. Fantastic by Calzaghe.
And the referee has a look. Lacy says, come on. He's put Lacy down. Down for the first time in his career. He says it wasn't a knockdown, but he gets the count. He's getting an 8 count. And the referee says, walk forward, are you okay to go long? I don't think he is. There's 2 minutes left, and Calzaghe rains punches in again. He's trying to take Lacy out of there.
Oh, he's totally gone. Look at him hanging on for dear life. Took a step behind Calzaghe to buy precious seconds. If Joe can just land one more clean shot, this fight is thank you and good night.
We've seen some terrific fights on ITV, and this is right up there with any performance that has been produced, I'm sure, by a British fighter. Calzaghe has been magnificent tonight. Absolutely magnificent.
Well, I can't remember a fighter being so dominant against such a dangerous opponent, probably, but not for the last probably 10 years. He's dominated every round.
All around at ringside, people are standing up to get a closer look at this. And back into the corner goes Lacy to have binding reattached on his glove, and that'll give him precious seconds. Joe Calzaghe just needs to keep his composure, keep his concentration. He's waving to the crowd, and the cheers of response are instantaneous. Calzaghe is starting to celebrate the greatest performance of his boxing career. Lacy comes forward to take yet more.
Got him again. Beautiful shots. This has been an absolute masterclass from Joe Calzaghe.
Last few seconds of a superb, wonderful boxing display from Joe Calzaghe.
And I'm glad to say I told you so.
Yep, good pick, good pick. He has silenced the doubters. Calzaghe is boxing his way to a magnificent points victory. Quite outstanding. Staying up, a peach of a right uppercut from Calzaghe. The bell is about to sound. Calzaghe still picking his man off.
Congratulations, Joe Calzaghe.
They want him to call him out. Gary Shaw is shouting across the corner, get him out of there. Well, that's it, it's all over. Lacy comes forward, embraces Calzaghe, but let the doubters be silenced. Joe Calzaghe is absolutely, utterly top-notch, and he is now getting a rightful embrace from his father and trainer, Enzo Calzaghe, because I don't really think that it gets very much better. That was quite outstanding.
John, I can't remember seeing such an emphatic victory over, as I said before, a really good champion. Lacy's a puncher, but Calzaghe nullified him from start to finish, outboxed him, outpunched him, outsped him. Fantastic performance.
Calzaghe has gone to all corners of this Manchester arena and shouted out to the crowd, who's best? Who's best? And I tell you what, that is the performance of the best fighter in Britain for me. No question.
Undoubtedly, pound for pound now, Calzaghe's got to be like maybe probably top three in the world. You won't see a more clinical display of boxing than that anywhere on this planet.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing, we have a unanimous decision. Here are the score totals. Judging ringside, Nelson Vasquez scores the bout 119 to 105. Judges Adelaide Bird and Roy Francis both score the bout 119 to 107. All three in favor of the winner. And now the unified super middleweight champion of the world, the Pride of Wales, Joe Calzaghe.
We have a Welsh celebration in Manchester. We have a British celebration and a celebration of the very best in boxing. Joe Calzaghe has been a professional since 1993. 41 fights undefeated. Here in 2006, he has the best win of his professional career.
Joe Calzaghe, you were sensational tonight. You said he was made for you. Not everybody believed you. You were spot on.
Yeah, well, I can't explain how happy I am at the moment. You know, this is a fight, and me and Frank, we've been after this fight to bring, I've already said, a better opponent, the better I perform. You know what I mean? I have to perform against the best operators, then you see the best of Joe Calzaghe. So I think I performed well, you know. He's a world-class fighter, and I think I won every single round, you know. And I was in great shape, thanks to my dad. He is, without him, I wouldn't be here today. He's a great trainer, great dad, loving a bit. Yeah, thanks, really. Thanks to Joe. Thanks to my little kids, Joe and Connor. See you Monday. I love you both.
Listen, you gave him a boxing lesson. You boxed his head off in there. It must have been the performance of your life.
I knew I had to box because the only chance he had was to stand toe-to-toe. I slipped up a few times, nearly Barry Mitchell fight, Charles Brewer fight. My dad told me, you're going to need to box this guy. I think I showed everybody tonight I'm a better boxer than I'm a fighter. I spoke to Barry. Barry said the same for Frank. I had to keep on the back foot, jab, move, boxing skills. And thank God, I think I've done good.
We could pick any round out to show you. We've got a bit of action from the third, which was absolutely phenomenal. I think at one stage, Duke McKenzie counted 10 unanswered punches going in there. I mean, it was just a boxing education.
Yeah, it was. I knew I had to keep him on the back foot, sharp jab. You know, he's good coming forward. But to be honest, I hurt my hand about the 8th round again. Couldn't put my full power on my left. See, look, my boxing skill, I was way too fast for him. The only chance he had was to stand toe-to-toe and land a big shot, but I concentrated for the entire 12 rounds, and you know, thank God I put a great performance when I had to.
You worried about that left hand. We worried about it. Did I understand you right there, Joe? You said it went in the 8th again.
I hurt it, and hopefully it's not right. It doesn't feel as bad as it did last time, but I hurt it. But I'm not surprised, you know. You see them punches landing on his head, you're going to get sore hands, you know.
I have to say to you, not bad for an old slapper.
Not bad for a slapper. Like I said, you know, he come in that ring and underestimate my power. And not once did he hurt me, not once did he trouble me. In fact, I was quite surprised. I expected his punches to be harder than they were. I've been in with harder punches. That was, you know, I didn't box for 6 months. There's better to come.
Did you feel the corner should have pulled him out?
No, you can't say that. Listen, he's a true warrior. He's a champion, you know. That's the game. If I'm in that position, I want to continue. That's we are warriors in that ring, you know.
Let's have a quick word with your dad, your trainer. You did it your way. You worked away around the valleys. You got your man in great shape. You must be the proudest dad in the world.
Without a question of doubt. I mean, what we did today is something I always knew he was going to do. I spoke with Barry many times. I spoke with Frank. And this was just the goals that he needed. It's a style, you know, at the end of the day, the better opponent, as Joe, you know yourself, the better boxer. Today was absolutely splendid. I would put that probably one of the best performances of his life since I've trained him. That's 25 years. So
it was one of the great British performances in a world title fight ever. You're not going to shift him up now, are you? He's quite tidy at this weight, isn't he?
I might give him a couple of pork pies now. We'll see what goes on from there.
I might go attach these belts.
Just finally, what are getting those two belts around you? What does it mean to you after all those people saying he hasn't fought anybody, he's a paper, he's a featherweight champion? What does it mean to you to get those two belts in your hands?
I've been for years a top 10 pound-for-pound fighter in the world. And I think I needed the chance to prove it. And I think tonight I proved I'm a top 10 world fighter. And I'm looking for them big fights. Tava, we are frank now, after that performance, I think I deserve the big, massive fights and paydays.
A command performance, a boxing masterpiece. Many good judges are convinced this was the best display by a British fighter on these shores. No one gave Lacy a round. He was hit by an astonishing 1,006 punches. It was faultless. Modest Joe was spellbinding. Judgment Day became Coronation Day for Joe Calzaghe, now recognised as a great champion who's on top of the world.
Well, Calzaghe right now was what you're getting. You know, we're so used to seeing him fight like this.
Okay. Good straight right-hand lead he had in there. Now here comes Lacy, desperately trying to come in and wing hooks. There's his girlfriend, Jennifer, in the corner, trying to urge her man forward, but Calzaghe doesn't box his way out of it. He tries to get into a trading session.
And Calzaghe's obviously learned from his mistakes, because when he starts his combination, he keeps his chin down. When he's been hurt or he gets backed up, he keeps his chin down as he starts to throw his shots. Look where his chin is, right in his chest. He doesn't want to leave it hanging out to dry. He's boxing a great fight.
Lacy did get in with a left uppercut, as you were saying that, Duke. Just got in close. Calzaghe takes it well, though. Been down in a couple of fights recently against Byron Mitchell, Kabari Salem. That was an untidy fight, but Calzaghe was right in the middle of a messy divorce at that time, and thankfully for him, that's behind him now.
Joe took a right hand there off Lacy, but he's still there, obviously.
Lacy's probably having his best round of the fight so far.
Yeah, just landing one or two cleaner shots. He's getting outworked, but he's starting to get through on Calzaghe. Calzaghe's still winning this round for me, though.
He's going to have a headache tonight, as Mr. Lacy. taken so many shots, and again, flurries of punches from Calzaghe.
Well, I want to see what Lacy says after this fight, if Calzaghe goes on to be victorious, which I think he will be.
Well, he's moaning about use of the head from Calzaghe.
He wants to get on with it because this is World Championship Boxing and anything goes. He's getting worked over and he doesn't like it.
Calzaghe, I think, is starting to tee himself up for the big attack. I think he might be looking to take him out here. Two big left hands, and Lacy is on the receiving end of a barrage of punches. Calzaghe wants to get him out of there.
His legs have gone, John. He's all over the place. He's hanging on for dear life. He's trying his fight back, but Joe's just going to be a better punch, pick his punches better and get him out of there.
Somehow Lacy has seen it through to the bell. Calzaghe says something as he goes back, and he goes back to the corner where he gets terrific words of encouragement from Enzo Calzaghe. Lacy has never been down, but my goodness, he nearly went then. He came so close to being put down by those two left hands. There has not been one moment in this fight where Calzaghe has surrendered the initiative, and a punch count there would have revealed, I think, something in the region of 40 punches or more, which hammered in on Lacy in the last 15 seconds or so there. Dramatic.
Well, I said, you know, the worst thing Lacy can do is to hit Calzaghe and hurt him, because when Calzaghe recovers, he's like an out of control. Okay. And that's what we just saw. Just quality punches. Lacy doesn't have the footwork to get out of the way. This fight could be over very shortly.
It's in all Calzaghe. I've got it as a complete shutout so far, Duke. Absolutely everything going to Calzaghe.
You know, Lacy was the betting favourite, but I just figured that he hadn't boxed anybody near of Calzaghe's class or stature.
6-4 on he was. 11-10 against Calzaghe. They were tasty looking odds. Still a chance for Lacy. While there's life, there's hope.
Oh, this is just, you know, Calzaghe's got his number. What a beautiful little combination. He's picking his punches beautifully. We're going right down the middle.
The hand has held together well. Dean Powell's done a good job binding up that weak left hand. I don't think there was too much sparring, if any, in the preparations of Joe Calzaghe for this fight. But then he's never been a big man for sparring in the gym, concentrating on fitness, boxing ability, and innate desire to win. He has a real winner's mentality, does the Welshman.
Now, how he's done it for this long, you know, 40-fight unbeaten record. You know, never ducked anybody, Calzaghe. You've got to really hand it to this boy.
Good left-hand lead from Lacy there. He's caught Calzaghe as he came in. Lacy's just plodding. Straight left, and another left hand from Lacy. And is Lacy at last just starting to get to Calzaghe a little bit more, I wonder? Calzaghe, if he performs to type, will try and produce something terrific to catch the judges' eyes in the second half of this round.
It's a much closer round this round. Joe's probably needed to start just a little step off the gas, but as I say that, he comes back with a nice four-punch flurry. Beautiful boxing again.
Got himself into terrific shape. He's up on his toes, looking fresh and sharp, even at this stage.
Yeah, and let's not forget, you know, Lacy's been used to fighting on American soil, but now he's away from home. You know, I don't see him raising his game like he can do when he's back home.
Calzaghe's just allowed his work rate to drop a little bit in this eighth round, but then that's almost inevitable after the ferocious pace of the early stages.
Yeah, Joe's just looking just a little bit tired in this round. But, you know, you can't fault him for that because he's really worked hard. But Lacy's not paying him. He's not capitalising on what is actually happening in the fight.
Lacy has bull-like strength and he's trying to come charging in behind that spear of a left-hand lead. Calzaghe quieter this round. Has Lacy done enough to edge it? I'm not sure. Good uppercut inside from Calzaghe. And another one. Headshots, all scoring shots from Calzaghe.
Well, Lacy breathing really heavily now as he soaks these punches up.
Well, that's the flurry of punches that we wanted to see from Calzaghe from a British point of view. right in control. See what Barry McGuigan's making of it so far. You had your doubts beforehand,
yeah,
Barry.
I worried about him, but I have to tell you, he's been absolutely exemplary. Boxing brilliantly. What we, I suppose, overlooked was his speed, and certainly Jeff Lacy's overlooked his speed. He has absolutely bombarded Lacy, and Lacy has very little left in him. If he gets through another round of this, and remember, in the last round, Lacy took the round, or Calzaghe took the round off. He took an easy round. If he turns it on in this round, I'd be very surprised if Dan Birmingham doesn't pull Lacy out. He's taken an absolute hammering. There's very little left in him.
He's taking a pounding, and look at those shots which went in the closing seconds of that round. And Lacy, well, I was interviewed by one or two American journalists and American TV stations, and they looked at me with a look of bemusement when I said that Calzaghe might just be able to box this guy's head off. And they sort of thought I'd lost my sense of reason, but there you go.
Well, you know, John, you're not the only one that thought Calzaghe would do this. You know, I know for a fact that his manager, promoter, Frank Warren's had a big bet on his boy, so... You know, he's not about to put him in a fight that he doesn't think he can't win. And, what a gamble. He's paying off. So far, it's paying off. Lacy's going to need the knockout, you know, just to get back on even terms.
Gary Shaw, Lacy's promoter, bellowing at him while Calzaghe, just having the binding on his glove, fixed by the corner. He is 8 rounds down, I reckon, Jeff Lacy.
That's good boxing by Calzaghe. Nice high guard. You know, just pecking away at the jab. Tying Lacy up. Sorry, John, just tying Lacy up on the inside there.
One, two, long punches.
Left lead again from Lacy. Calzaghe, good body shot. Good left hand. Oh, beautiful. Nice uppercut.
Absolutely beautiful. That's world-class boxing. Beautiful left uppercut by Calzaghe, right up the pipe.
He said he wants Clinton Woods next as Joe Calzaghe. Clinton said he thought Calzaghe would beat Lacy. And if he's watching this, I wonder if he might be thinking twice about the possibility of going into the ring against Calzaghe. You remember, he said he would love to be a world champion at two weights, as well as unifying this title. Mikael Kessler, the Dane, is a spectator here, the WBA super middleweight champion. That's another possibility.
There's a big left hook there landed by Lacy, though. Calzaghe, for the first time in the fight, actually grimaced in a little bit of pain.
Forward comes Lacy, trying to, you can see why he's trying to set himself, trying to give himself an opportunity to throw that bingo right hand.
You know, let's not forget, Calzaghe's, I believe, has boxed at a much higher level, and he's been in world title fights and won with one hand previously, but thankfully tonight both hands have held up, and this is the sort of boxing that he can demonstrate.
Oh, that is superb. Knocking the head of Lacy around. Oh, look at that.
He's treating Lacy with contempt.
That is an Ray Leonard trick.
Absolute contempt. Beautiful boxing by Calzaghe. Fantastic, winding up the right hand, showing him the jab, hitting him with the left hook. Well, this is what a true world champion is made of. When you can dismantle a rival champion with the consummate ease that Calzaghe is, you know, this is a sign of the man's class.
I think he could be close to being stopped here, Lacy. The referee should be having a good look at this, and I think that a compassionate corner might also be taking a good look at him, because he is taking round after round of sustained pounding now, and Calzaghe is producing every shot in the textbook. All Calzaghe.
Every round, I've given him every round. I've struggled to give Lacy even a share of one of the rounds.
Another big, big round. And how much more can he take? Those eyes are closing. Wow. He's cut badly.
What round is it?
He's hurting.
Ninth.
He's saying, what round is it?
Okay. All right. How you feel?
Well, he says he's okay. He could have fooled me. Punch after punch from Calzaghe. And so Calzaghe saying, suck it up, dig deep, don't let it go away. away. Calzaghe in sight of achieving one of his fighting dreams, and we're adding another title and beating an American star.
Well, Lacy looks tired, he looks dejected and looks incredibly sorry for himself. You know, really slow getting off the corner now. Almost punched to a standstill on that last round. This is absolutely textbook boxing from Calzaghe. He's not done nothing flash, he's not taken any chances. He's boxed well within himself.
He's been the 12 round distance 8 times to Joe Calzaghe. Lacy 3. Calzaghe knows exactly what it takes to win a fight. And here he is getting back behind the jab.
Lovely right left uppercut from Calzaghe. Fantastic shot. He just shortened his punches up on the inside, which is what you'd expect with a short arm fighter like Lacy. He would be better at the inside work. But Calzaghe's met him on the inside and totally outboxed him.
Lacy turned professional in 2001. By then, Calzaghe had been a world champion for more than 3 years. It's been a steep learning curve for Lacy from there. Was he overhyped? Maybe.
Well, I wouldn't say he was overhyped.
But I do think that Calzaghe here tonight has produced. But, you know, I mean, he said that his performance against Chris Eubank was the best of his career, the hardest fight he's ever had. I think this is absolutely vintage Calzaghe. I think tonight he's been brilliant.
Absolutely, and I'll have to second that. The guy hasn't put a foot wrong all night long against the young, hungry, unbeaten champion, rival champion at that, you know, IBF champion. But it looks like if Calzaghe can maintain this for the remainder of this fight, beautiful by Calzaghe. Look what a lovely left uppercut. They've obviously worked on that punch in the gym. It's paid off for him all night long.
You're watching one of the outstanding British champions in Joe Calzaghe. One of the very best. And Jeff Lacy looks disconsolate, doesn't he? He looks in some distress, he looks bemused, he's banging his gloves together, he's bravely coming forward. Well, I could imagine, sorry Duke, I could imagine many a fight where this might have been stopped by now. If this wasn't a world title fight, I think Lacy would have been out of there. Good work again from Calzaghe, and look at the spring in his step, still up on his toes.
Pure class from Calzaghe, leading with a straight left right hook.
Oh, superb again.
Lacy's just getting beaten to the punch every time. Toe, outboxed, outpunched, outmaneuvered.
And he shook his head disconsolately. Came forward and was promptly bundled through the ropes by Calzaghe. Another great round for Calzaghe. Utterly in control. Is that 10 rounds gone? I've given him everyone.
Everyone, John. I've struggled to give Lacy one round.
Well, there's his girlfriend, Joe Calzaghe's girlfriend, that is. And she'll be delighted with the way things are going.
Absolutely fantastic.
Absolutely fantastic, says Enzo Calzaghe. And well, he might.
It was just beautiful boxing by Calzaghe. Look at the way he leads off with the straight left. Well, in this instance, you know, like a 4-5 punch flurry, 6-7, 8 punches, all unanswered. It's as much as Lacy can do now to muster another attack. He's desperately tired. You know, I can see Calzaghe maybe stopping him in this round. If he really steps on it and goes for it, he could get a stoppage. There's no need, obviously.
Should he be left out to take more? He's going. Round 11. And it just continues. More of the same. That's not a knockdown, that was a push.
Calzaghe is. Okay, Lacy lost his footing, but Calzaghe gave him a little shove. So take that with you.
And it shows that Lacy is just about spent, I think.
Yeah, he got nothing left. You know, he hasn't been able to get his confidence with his big left hook, which he bragged about, you know, throughout all of the build-up to the fight. Hasn't been able to hit the target at all, not cleanly. So as I said before, he's been outboxed, outmaneuvered, outpunched now by Calzaghe.
He said to me that if it goes to the decision, if it goes to the judges' cards, he wasn't sure that he'd get a very good decision from the judges. I think on that one, he's probably right. Calzaghe is absolutely a mile in front.
Well, he's been absolutely amazing tonight. Let's not forget, John, this, you know, we've said it before, this isn't another defence. he's fighting a rival champion. Some would have said that Lacy was, you know, on paper at least, a better fighter than Calzaghe. We always thought he was a harder puncher, but Calzaghe hasn't allowed him to land his punches. He's nullified everything Lacey's tried to do. He just totally demoralised him and outboxed him.
There's a lot of people who thought that Lacy was going to win this fight. And when they look back at this one and assess it, perhaps that should be remembered. Here comes Lacy, bravely coming forward once more. Calzaghe's binding around his right glove is coming loose. And now we go to the corner again to get that glove bound. Yeah, I say, Duke, I mean, when they come to assess this fight, so don't doubt there'll be some who say Lacy just wasn't what he was built up to be, but it's very easy to be wise after the event. There are an enormous number of people, and not just commentators, I'm talking about people within the sport, who thought that Calzaghe was going to go, that he was ready to be taken.
Well, sure, there'd been one or two chinks in the armour, but what Calzaghe's proven to you, he's proven the doubt was wrong. He's got himself in absolutely tip-top shape. We haven't had a problem with the hands, and he's boxed textbook boxing.
Here comes Calzaghe again. Is he looking for the stoppage even at this stage?
Well, Lacy looks spent. He looks absolutely out on his feet.
The referee ought to be stopping this. He's getting an absolute hiding, is Lacy, and you worry about what sort of damage this is having to him. This is a career-ending fight.
Gone.
He's never going to be the same again after this, I don't think.
He's got nothing left, John. He's got nothing left.
The referee ought to be stepping in to stop this one.
Come on, John. Fantastic. Oh, this is just breathtaking stuff from Calzaghe. You know, I remember this boy. He was on a couple of my shows when he was just turned professional. Mickey Duff said, watch out for this kid. He's going to be something special.
Well, there wasn't wrong with that.
But since taking over from Frank Warren...
Oh, he's taken the point away from Joe Calzaghe. No. Can you believe that?
Oh, well, that's being kind to Lacy. That's the first round I've given him.
Well, I don't know what that's about. I suppose Calzaghe won the round, so it's actually scored a level round, isn't it? You can't... Even losing a point, you can't give that to Lacy.
You're fantastic, right? This guy's fucko, this is you stop him last round. He's gonna be stopped now. He's gonna stop him now. Get the jab working, mate. Go for it.
Here's the attack from Calzaghe. I think the referee should have been stepping in there, Duke.
Well, Lacy took so many unanswered shots.
Here's the
little backhander, that's why he's done it.
Well, maybe with sober reflection, the referee spotted it. Let's see what's happening in the Lacy corner.
Last round, baby, you gotta do it. You gotta do it, baby. Last round.
You gotta let your hands go. You got 3 minutes to get this guy out.
Come on, baby, you gotta do it. You can say that again. If he could turn this round, it would be the most extraordinary turnaround in a fight I think that I've ever seen. Calzaghe has been superb tonight, absolutely superb.
Well, he hasn't put a foot wrong all night, John. There's nothing to suggest that he's about to do that. You know, the spring in his step, the snap in his punches. It's Lacy who's obviously the desperate one. And the desperate man can often be hurt, but he can be dangerous. But Calzaghe's a fighter through and through.
Can Calzaghe take him out, even at this late stage?
He's going again for him. Watch Lacy's legs, they're gone. Referee looks like he might step in here, John. He's gone, John, he's absolutely gone. Referee's got him intervene. Look at his punches, I'm out to. Fantastic by Calzaghe.
And the referee has a look. Lacy says, come on. He's put Lacy down. Down for the first time in his career. He says it wasn't a knockdown, but he gets the count. He's getting an 8 count. And the referee says, walk forward, are you okay to go long? I don't think he is. There's 2 minutes left, and Calzaghe rains punches in again. He's trying to take Lacy out of there.
Oh, he's totally gone. Look at him hanging on for dear life. Took a step behind Calzaghe to buy precious seconds. If Joe can just land one more clean shot, this fight is thank you and good night.
We've seen some terrific fights on ITV, and this is right up there with any performance that has been produced, I'm sure, by a British fighter. Calzaghe has been magnificent tonight, absolutely magnificent.
Well, I can't remember a fighter being so dominant against such a dangerous opponent probably, but not for the last probably 10 years, he's dominated every round.
All around at ringside, people are standing up to get a closer look at this. And back into the corner goes Lacy to have binding reattached on his glove, and that'll give him precious seconds. Joe Calzaghe just needs to keep his composure, keep his concentration. He's waving to the crowd, and the cheers of response are instantaneous. Calzaghe is starting to celebrate the greatest performance of his boxing career. Lacy comes forward to take yet more.
Got him again. Beautiful shots. This has been an absolute masterclass from Joe Calzaghe.
Last few seconds of a superb, wonderful boxing display from Joe Calzaghe. Suggestion that the referee is saying that to this point. And there's an air of desperation about the work of Jeff Lacy. He knows that he's cut, he may not have been hurt, at least not hurt badly, but the fight is going against him because Calzaghe is giving him a boxing lesson.
Well, there was scar tissue coming into on his left eye coming into this fight, and the cuts opened up, I think, on the right eye. I'm not exactly sure.
It is the right eye, Duke.
Yeah, the right eye. But Calzaghe is actually doing a number on him. His boxing is such an intelligent fight. You know, Lacy looks just a little bit desperate, a little bit clumsy. Doesn't have the same footwork as Calzaghe, doesn't have the hand speed of Calzaghe.
Nigel Benn said this week that if Calzaghe had been around in his era, the era of Chris Eubank, of Steve Collins, of Michael Watson, he could have stood the test with all of them. Clash of heads inside there. Lacy came boring in low, but he took a load of punches from Calzaghe as well, flurries of shots. And Lacy, for all his attempts to force the fight here, has not landed really one clean shot, for my way of looking at it, on Calzaghe in this round.
Yeah, there's been nothing of real any significance landed by Lacy. Sure, he's forcing the fight, but Calzaghe's just totally dominating and outworking him.
Closing stage from the fourth, and it's another Calzaghe round, and look at this! Terrific work from Calzaghe! And it's a bad one over the left eye, and I think the right eye is damaged as well. His face is a mess, and it's not, I don't think, clashes of heads that's done that. It's been the accuracy, the precision and sheer brilliance of Calzaghe's punching. They've got to do something to stop that. That is a mess. They don't appear to be doing anything with that cut.
Close your ass.
Jeff, okay. Jab right hand, you got to get off first. You're waiting.
All right.
You're waiting, Jeff. Jab right hand and let him go.
Bad damage to the eyes of Jeff Lacy. And what a spectacular onslaught from Calzaghe. There was a clash of heads there, but that's not damaged the eye. That's hit him low. Not that clash of heads which has caused the damage. Not to my way of looking at it. And they're very slow to get out of the corner there. Deep cuts on Lacy's face. Fight should be underway. And the corner men in the Lacy camp very slow to get out. And Calzaghe may be on his way now towards victory. Surely he's won all four rounds, but he can't get careless. Lacy still has that power.
Lacy really needs to get at the races now and try and, you know, assert himself in this fight, because he's in danger now of not only being stopped but probably being on cuts, but he's being outworked and outboxed like Calzaghe.
Desperation from Lacy as he comes forward trying to wing those trademark hooks, catches Calzaghe with one there, but so far the overhand right, which is a real danger punch, hasn't been in evidence. Calzaghe's kept him away, and another lovely flurry of punches from Calzaghe.
Right now, Lacy doesn't appear to have an answer to the southpaw style. It's causing him all kinds of problems because he's catching everything on the way in. There's no lateral movement from Lacy, and this is probably one of his biggest downfalls. Sure, he's got the power, sure, he's got the skill, sure, he's got the arsenal, but he doesn't have the lateral movement to get out of the way of what's coming back at him.
Although he wouldn't say as much, I always got the impression there was just a hint of jealousy and maybe even a tad of resentment in Joe Calzaghe about the lack of recognition for his achievements and the fantastic support up here in Manchester for Ricky Hatton. Well, here tonight he's proved himself to be a fighter of the very top draw so far, and Ricky Hatton, who's in this crowd, I'm sure is watching on with a great deal of admiration.
But Lacy's punches are very predictable, and Calzaghe can read them really easily at this point. But he's found lovely combinations, and Lacy's face is a mess.
This last 12 rounds, goodness knows what sort of state Lacy's face is going to be in by the end of it. Already in the fifth round, he looks as though he has had an absolute pounding, and another straight left thuds in towards those damaged eyes.
Lacy's really struggling with this one, I promise you. Not only from the cuts, but he just can't work out this style. He can't get his punches off. It feels like he's given him another boxing lesson.
He's had his ears boxed off. Lacy said, southpaw style doesn't matter one jot to me. I've had goodness knows how many rounds sparring with Winky Wright, but so far he's had no answer to this. Calzaghe bullies Lacy back across the ring. The referee says don't do that, but it's not a tea party.
Lacy's just ploughing forward, but he's not throwing anything. He's like a catcher at the minute, he's like a catcher's mitt. He's just catching everything that Calzaghe's throwing. He can't keep his combinations going. He can't match Calzaghe for hand speed or work rate.
Calzaghe's contemptuously now dropping his gloves, almost inviting Lacy in. Well, the rout continues. All Calzaghe, and that, oh dear me, that face is just a mess. That is a mess. And look at the eyes of Jeff Lacy. I thought at the press conference on Thursday, behind that grim, threatening demeanour lurks genuine tension, if not fear, of what might be coming. Now he knows his worst nightmares are coming. Lacy has been on the receiving end of a non-stop pounding in this fight. Five rounds out of five to Joe Calzaghe, and the Welshman so far is having things his own way and is boxing quite superbly.
You know, they're waiting for the pace to drop, but he's going to be waiting all night, because Calzaghe can do this all night long. But he mustn't get overconfident. He has to stick with his game plan, hit and not get hit. Tie Lacy up, spin off, and just go missing, and keep feeding him his stream of accurate, brilliant, quite brilliant combinations.
I'm sure in the corner, Enzo Calzaghe will have been drumming in the instruction, keep working off the jab, try and keep it at range. There it goes, rocking back the head of Lacy.
See, it's okay for Lacy to, you know, get fed a string of guys that he can just stand in front of him, and you know, they're almost fearful, because once they get in front of him, they see this muscle man in front of them, and then they end up getting knocked out. But Calzaghe won't stand for anything like that.
Calzaghe's never had the respect he should have had in the United States, through no fault of his own. He didn't get the contests against the likes of Roy Jones and Bernard Hopkins, and look at that quality. There must have been about a 7 or 8 punch flurry of blows there aimed by Calzaghe, and I think just about every one of them hit. Another good left hand, and Lacy is starting to look bemused, befuddled, and utterly on his way towards defeat.
He's coming apart at the seams, John. What a beautiful combination we got there from Calzaghe. Controlled, pinpoint, accurate punches. 4, 5, 6, 7 punches all hit on the mark, on the button. Lacy looks really sorry for himself, and he's getting more and more banged up in there.
It's not only Lacy who looks sorry for himself. Gary Shaw, his promoter on the far side of the ring, looks one of the most shell-shocked men I've seen in a long time. Shelley Finkel, one-time manager of Mike Tyson, isn't exactly putting out the bunting either. There's the right hand, though. That's the danger shot.
All heads spinning dangerously close there from both boxers.
There was a right hand over the top from Lacy, which did get in.
Yeah, Calzaghe felt that, but he's still winning the round.
Flooding right hand. Wonder how much more of this Lacy can take.
Yeah, Joe's he's gonna be tired, isn't he? Let's get it right. He's thrown a hell of a lot of punches. You know, but Lacy's not capitalised on this.
Only one punch though, Duke. It can still turn round. Don't count chickens. Calzaghe is boxing superbly. He's winning the fight, but Lacy is still in there. Blood now seeping from his lower lip. Oh, headshots. Those are the slaps, and he slaps hard.
Let's go, Joe Calzaghe.
Relaxed and confident.
You're sickening him now, Joe.
Absolutely on his game, isn't he? Look at that superb flurry of punches. I said 7 or 8. There might have been 9 or 10.
It was 10 unanswered shots. 9 out of the 10 hit the target. What a fantastic boxing we've got from Joe Calzaghe.
Marvin Hagler said he deserves to be ranked in the best 6 in the world, pound for pound. Jeff Lacy was supposed to be the coming star. Doesn't look like one there. It's been all Joe Calzaghe as we move into the second half of the fight.
Yeah, I've got Calzaghe winning everything. I think he's absolutely boxed rings around Lacy. He's absolutely given him a boxing lesson.
Calzaghe, in case I needed to remind you, of course, the taller man in the black and white shorts. Lacy, the man who's been battered from pillar to post for 18 minutes. Blood flying across our commentary position. Maybe coming from the eye of Jeff Lacy, no doubt.
This is all typical, might be a little bit fragile, but you watch him when he starts to go to work.
Calzaghe's boxed quite neatly in this opening period. He's favouring the right hand, clearly. But so far, he's got the speed to just jab his way in and then content to tie Lacy up in close. And Calzaghe will be happy with the way this first round has gone.
Lacy can't match Calzaghe for work rate.
He's just coming crouching in. There's a right hand. That's the best shot from Lacy so far. That's the danger punch.
That shot, Calzaghe.
This is what you get from Calzaghe. Good headshots.
This is what you get from Calzaghe when he's hurt. He's like an out-of-control winger. He just starts firing shots.
Well, that's the first round to Calzaghe, but he did take a big right hand. Calzaghe working well behind the jab in the early exchanges. And then the flurry of punches when the action really hotted up.
Game plan. I want one round now, your boxer's ass off.
In the other corner, Dan Birmingham is the trainer speaking to Jeff Lacy.
Put your left foot outside. Listen, it's normal. Step quick. Hands lead. Bang, bang. Drop that jab and bring the hook. He's dropping his hands. He's wide open. He's squared up.
Already the nose of Lacy seeping blood. There's that right hand from Calzaghe, but back came the Welshman, and he returned it with interest.
Well, Calzaghe's drawn first blood. Can't afford to take any sort of unnecessary risks against such a dangerous opponent, or champion, I should say, in Jeff Left Hook Lacy.
Yeah, you have to sort of pinch yourself to remember this is not just a title defence for Calzaghe. This is him trying to add another world championship belt.
Beautiful left uppercut inside there by Calzaghe.
Lacy going, looking for headshots. These are the danger punches. That right hand is the one Calzaghe cannot afford to get caught with. Calzaghe outworking Lacy at this stage. Lacy trying to drag Calzaghe down onto the punch on the blind side of the referee. Calzaghe himself spinning Lacy now and trying to work away on the ropes. Good work rate from the 33-year-old undefeated Welshman.
See Calzaghe pacing himself. He's boxing an intelligent fight thus far.
There's a low one there from Lacy.
Also, Calzaghe's got his protector pulled up as high as he can possibly get it, which is what we're not really accustomed to with Calzaghe, but we know Lacy bangs well to the body.
Oh, good uppercut from Calzaghe, really good shot. Lacy takes it well. Remember, Lacy was stung in the early stages when he fought Omar Sheikha. That was arguably the hardest title defence so far, and he came back and won it well in the end. Good jab from Lacy this time, snapping shots, and Calzaghe just walked onto that one.
I just feel Calzaghe's getting engaged a little bit too early for my liking. I'd like to see him use the ring more. Not be flash, just be sensible. You know, use the ring more, try and put some points in the bag. Try and make Lacy look a little bit cumbersome, because Lacy doesn't quite have Calzaghe's footwork or hand speed.
Calzaghe needs to snap the jab. Needs to work behind that right hand lead. That's his key to this fight.
That's better boxing from Calzaghe. And a little treble jab and just a little step off. You know, make Lacy, make him miss, make him pay. Lovely right uppercut.
Calzaghe is outboxing Lacy at this stage. But it's a 12-round fight, and a little contemptuous smile from Calzaghe as he tags Lacy almost at will. Lacy wants this to be a tear-up. He's trying to urge Calzaghe in.
Well, this is pretty much what I thought we'd get from Lacy. He's not getting it his own way, and he's already starting to complain.
This is a really good start from Calzaghe, but Lacy now is into his face, and that's where he wants to be. Good uppercut again from Calzaghe, picking the shot well, and nothing coming back in there from Lacy. It's all Calzaghe in that exchange. Well, a brilliant opening from Joe Calzaghe. Dan Birmingham, Lacy's trainer, protesting vociferously to the referee about something.
Don't try to loop the hand, right hand right now. Let him wear out a little bit. Straight punch, straight punch. Bang, bang, right hand. Bring the hook up to the body. Bring it up.
Trying to get those hooks into play. They call him left hook Lacy. We've not seen it yet. What a good start to this fight from Joe Calzaghe. Really good effort. Lacy at the moment is being set problems to which he doesn't have the answer.
Well, you've got to expect a change of tactics from Lacy. He's going to have to really start to bully Calzaghe. He's going to have to up his work rate, but then you can expect Calzaghe to go straight with him.
Oh, good shot from Calzaghe. Short, straight left. Lacy into his face. Those are low punches, surely.
Yeah, this is getting really messy now.
But
really,
the referee can't see it. He saw where he was placed, right behind the back of Lacy. Calzaghe gets away with it.
Calzaghe's going to have to fight his way out of the corner.
He doesn't want to be in that sort of toe-to-toe terror.
A twist turn Lacy nicely there.
Well, that's good work from Calzaghe. Quality work, but can he keep this sort of intensity of performance, this sort of speed, this work rate, going for 12 rounds? Had to do it a few years ago against Charles Brewer down in Cardiff. That was a great fight that night.
Well, I think he can, John. Just needs to box sensible now. Needs to go missing. He's boxing fantastically well so far.
He's making Lacy look ponderous in there, but we know Lacy has fitness and strength. Blood is still seeping from Lacy's nostrils. Good right hand from Calzaghe. If he is the slapper that Jeff Lacy says, he slaps hard.
You know, this is going to be the hardest fight of Calzaghe's life, but right now he's boxing the fight of his life. Lovely combination. And then spins off and leaves Lacy to hit in thin air. He's boxing his head off.
He is giving him a boxing lesson.
Absolutely, John. Giving him an absolute boxing lesson. He's hitting him and he's not getting hit. This is fantastic boxing by Calzaghe.
Brilliant from Calzaghe at this stage. Can he keep it going, though? Lacy, the man with dynamite in his fists. We know he's a terrific puncher. Easy, easy goes at the chant. Well, I think that might be tempting fate just a little bit.
Well, it's not easy, John, because he's having to work for this.
Outstanding opening from Calzaghe. Won the first two rounds, and he's absolutely dominant in this third so far.
See, Lacy's just become very pedestrian, very one-paced. You know, like all punchers, has to rely on him setting his feet to get those big punches off. And while he's doing that, Calzaghe's outboxing him.
Well, I always thought Lacy was one-paced, Duke, but the thing about him is that he does bang that big right hand, and as Calzaghe tires, if he can't get Lacy out of there, as he tires, that could be more of a factor. But look at that hand speed from Calzaghe. That is exceptional, absolutely exceptional.
One, two, three punch combinations and then missing. Calzaghe just goes missing. Showing out now. His confidence is growing by the round.
Well, that is a brilliant 3 minutes boxing from Joe Calzaghe.
When you're inside like that, give him a little push.
Jeff Lacy can quite believe what's going on in there. He's finding no way of getting to Calzaghe after that right hand early on.
He's just trying to bomb everything.
He looks bemused.
Come on, you gave away the first three. You cannot keep that pace.
He cannot keep that pace, says Dan Birmingham.
Come on, Jeff.
Well, we will see.
Straight right hands. And drop them down a little bit.
Your jab is starting to get weaker. Big jab, right? Don't come. Keep it long.
A brilliant opening to this fight from Joe Calzaghe. Look at the hand speed and the mobility. If that's the performance of a waning fighter, it certainly doesn't look like it so far. But can he keep it up?
Yes, he can, John. We've seen this from Calzaghe before, and yes, he can keep this pace up. Lacy looking a little bit sorry for himself in his corner there. Corner just starting to get a little bit anxious now.
Enzo Calzaghe saying use the jab as Lacy tries to tee off an uppercut. He said to Calzaghe, box your way in, don't just get dragged into the terror. Well, Calzaghe almost showboating there, shows him the right hand and then landed a peach of a straight left. Calzaghe coming under attack himself.
Yeah, this is where Lacy wants it. He just wants to apply pressure on Calzaghe. You know, he's hoping that the pace will drop where he can land these big overhand rights and the famous left hook.
I assume you scored the first three rounds to Calzaghe, Duke.
I've given Calzaghe everything. And I'm not being biased. I just see Calzaghe outworking Lacy completely. Lacy's cut.
Lacy's cut around the right eye, and it doesn't look good. That's going to be a lot of work for the corner between rounds. Well, it looks as though it's that damaged left eye. He had scar tissue there, and it looks as though it's opened up again, and they're going to have a look at it, I think, are they? He's saying it's a clash of heads, is Lacy. It goes to the end of the fourth round. It goes to scorecards. This one is the fourth round. If it were to be stopped, if the referee says that it's an accidental clash of heads that's caused it, but no.
The early hours of the morning of Sunday, March the 5th. It's the one we've been waiting for. Judgment Day for Joe Calzaghe and Jeff Lacy, introduced by Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time has come for the bout you've all been waiting for, the unification showdown for the super middleweight championship of the world. Prepare to welcome the boxers as they make their way to the ring. First, ladies and gentlemen, entering to the red corner, the IBF and IBO world champion from St. Petersburg, Florida, in the United States, Jeff Lacy.
There's the IBF champion, Jeff Lacy. They say he's one of the hardest hitting fighters in the world in any division. And he says that the atmosphere here, a hostile atmosphere, will not affect him. I like being the underdog, he says. Well, here he is stepping into a crowd which must be 99% Joe Calzaghe. Cheers from the crowd. He's been pretty surly and non-communicative all week. He was a smiling figure when he came over a month or two ago when this fight was announced. But this week, he has just not wanted to know. Only stands about 5'9", but you'll see when he takes that tracksuit off, he has a physique which is absolutely ripped. He's in terrific condition. And here he is, Jeff Lacy, stepping into the ring, centre stage in the Manchester Arena, in front of some 16,000 fans. And they, to a man and woman, seem to be making him well aware of what they think. There's the IBF belt. And Lacy just content to prowl the ring. What sort of thoughts are going through that head? Is an appeal of a fight for the entire country. Calzaghe getting a colossal reception. Calzaghe has been here, done it so many times before, but never quite on a stage like this, in front of so many people. This is the defining fight he has craved. Now 33 years old, saluting his public. But how will his hand stand up? Is he fit enough to repel one of the meanest men in boxing? Rounds, it's due to go. 12 3-minute rounds, a unification fight, and there are the rules. No three knockdown rule, no standing eight count. The fighters cannot be saved by the bell. If there's an accidental clash of heads inside four rounds causing the end of the fight, it's no contest. After that, it goes to the cards. That's the rules for this fascinating fight. Enzo Calzaghe, father and trainer of Joe right the way through his career. A lot of experience in that corner. He will have to be absolutely at his very best if he's going to win this fight tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing to you our three judges scoring this bout from ringside. From Las Vegas, Nevada, in the United States, Adelaide Bird. From London, England, Roy Francis. And from San Juan, Puerto Rico, Nelson Vasquez. And introducing to you, ladies and gentlemen, our third man in the ring, working in this, his 90th world title bout, Raul Cais Sr. All right, fans, here we go. The time has come for the main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the unified super middleweight championship of the world. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, live from Manchester, England, it's showtime! Introducing to you first on my right, the WBO champion fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black trunks with white trim, hailing from Newbridge, South Wales. He weighed in at an even 12 stone, 168 68 US pounds. He is undefeated in his illustrious campaign of the ring with 40 wins, no losses, 31 wins coming by way of knockout tonight. He is making the 18th defense of his title. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the undefeated WBO super middleweight champion of the world. Please welcome the pride of Wales, introducing Joe. Across the ring, the IBF and IBO world champion on my left, fighting out of the red corner, entering the ring wearing red, white, and blue trunks, and fighting out of St. Petersburg, Florida, in the United States. His weight, 11 stone, 13 pounds, or 167 U.S. pounds. He is a U.S. Olympian, undefeated in the professional ranks, with a record of 21 wins, no losses, one no decision, with 17 wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, in his sixth appearance in the world title, here is the undefeated IBF and IBO super middleweight champion of the world, introducing Jeff Lacy. Once again, the referee in charge, Rolcase Senior, now to give instructions. 12 rounds of boxing scheduled.
Referee calling the two men together for final words of instruction.
All right, gentlemen, the time you've been waiting for is here. The opportunity of a lifetime, so remember, take advantage. You had your instructions, bone here, right here is fine, both of you got it, trunks high. Shake hands, good luck to both of you.
Well, this is the one we've been waiting for. The unification fight that Joe Calzaghe has craved for so long, it has arrived. 12 rounds, Joe Calzaghe against Jeff Lacy. They say it's the biggest super middleweight title fight since Roy Jones against James Toney back in 1994. Calzaghe fighting out of the southpaw stance, the taller man by a couple of inches. And will he be content to try and just box his way to victory?
I don't know if he's going to get the chance to box his way to victory because, you know, Lacy's just going to come looking for him. This is where he needs to have the fight up close.
Calzaghe breaking out of that clinch well with a right hand to the body, followed by the nice little jab into the face of Lacy. Another one. Calzaghe, I know, has been thinking he's got to try and keep his punches straight, try and fight at range as far as he can. But there is always that macho streak in Calzaghe. When he gets tagged, he likes to reply to fire with fire of his own. He started nice and confidently, though. Bit of attempted use of the head, I think, from Jeff Lacy in close. They made him shave off that beard that he's been sporting in the run-up to the fight.
Well, Calzaghe's got the higher work rate. You know, he can fight like this for 12 rounds, you know, at a much harder pace than Lacy. But Lacy obviously is the puncher of the two.
I do rather think that Calzaghe technically might be the better boxer. But is the edge in power with Lacy?
You know, Lacey's got scar tissue underneath his left eye. You know, he'd be the one to cut. I think if this is going to go to cuts or anything like it, but this is what you expect from Lacy, just going to come looking for Joe.
Right hand from Lacy, he landed one to the body and then a big swing, and straight away, as Calzaghe gets hit, he starts going into a tear-up. Here goes the work rate from Calzaghe. Remember, the left hand is the fragile one. He can't afford to have that one damaged. Just lost his balance slightly in that exchange. The Lacy camp have gambled that Calzaghe is a fighter in decline and that he's a man ready to be taken.
Joe's already started his assault. He's not really throwing too many headshots. He's aiming them at the body because he knows his hands.